हेलो फ्रेंड्स फ्रेंड्स, वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद शेयर कैपिटल, राइट। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड विद इशू ऑफ शेयर्स, राइट। आई टोल्ड यू दैट शेयर्स कैन बी इश्यूड इन प्राइवेट और टू द पब्लिक। प्राइवेट मीन्स टू अ स्पेसिफिक ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल यू आर इशूइंग द शेयर्स, and to the public means you are issuing the shares to the public, right? Then issue of shares can be for cash or for the consideration other than cash, clear? Then in cash, if we talk of issue of shares in cash, I told you that it can be in lump sum or in installments, right? Issue of shares for cash, then in cash it can be either lump sum or in installments, clear? So in the last lecture we did issue of shares in cash in lump sum. What we did in lump sum, that the whole amount is called at the time of application. What we ask the outsiders to send us the applications for the number of shares they want to subscribe, right, and send us the money along with the application, clear? We ask outsiders to give us a written application signed by them that how many shares they want to subscribe, and along with the application they should send the whole amount of money. That means if you are issuing 1 lakh shares of rupees 10 each, right, that means you are calling that this rupees 10 should be paid at the time of application. If a person wants to apply for 5000 shares of rupees 10 each, you say you bring 50,000 at the time of, sorry, yes, 50,000. 50,000 at the time of application only. 5,000 shares into rupees 10, 50,000 at the time of application, that person will have to pay. Clear? For that, I told you the journal entry is, first entry is we received application money. We say bank account debit to share application account, right? Then once we have received the applications, we decide whether the applications are to be accepted or rejected, right? If the applications are accepted, the next step is we have to allot the shares, right? The next step is allotment. At the time of allotment, what we do is we transfer this share application money to share capital. That means we tell people that whatever money we have received on application, that money becomes our capital now, to share capital account. Clear? That means we have transferred the share application money to share capital account. We have considered that money to be our capital now. This much we have discussed in the last lecture, right? When the whole money was called along with the application, clear? Now what we are going to do is issue of shares in cash in installments, right? Now how we do this? Suppose a company issued 1 lakh shares of rupees 10 each, right? Total amount is 10 lakh, clear? In the first case, I told you they called rupees 10 along with application. But the company may decide that we will call this rupees 10 in installments. What they will say, pay rupees 2 on 1 lakh shares, right, at the time of application. Okay, then they will say pay rupees 4 on 1 lakh shares at the time of allotment of shares. Clear? Then they say pay, the remaining is rupees 4 on 1 lakh shares when we make a call to you. When we ask you to pay, only then you pay. We will call you and tell you that you have to pay rupees 4 on 1 lakh shares. Clear? So this is how they have divided to call the shares. The first they say pay rupees 2 only on 1 lakh shares. If you want to subscribe 1 lakh shares, pay rupees 2 at the time of application, pay rupees 4 at the time of allotment, and pay rupees 4 on first and final call. Whenever we will call you, pay that 4 rupees. Is this much clear? So what they are asking is, they are asking at the time of application, they say give us the applications, bring applications. Along with applications, if you want to subscribe to 1 lakh shares, bring application for 1 lakh shares and pay rupees 2 on 1 lakh shares. Do not pay rupees 10, pay rupees 2 only. Right? Because we might reject your application, we might not accept your application, we will refund you rupees 2. Do not bring rupees 10, just bring rupees 2, a token money, a sort of token money, you can say. Clear? Like I told you, when you go to purchase a SIM card, a postpaid SIM card, what they do is, first of all, they will ask for that application, your signatures on application, and then they will say deposit 250 rupees, which will be adjusted against your bill or which will be refunded to you. Isn't it? So this 2 rupees is the deposit amount. Clear? Now, what are going to be the journal entries for this? Taking this example only, what will be the journal entry for this? First of all, we will receive applications. What will be the first entry? We will receive applications, and along with applications, what we are receiving is and application money, right? What is the journal entry for this? You all know, bank account debit to share application account. Now, what is the amount? They say on application pay rupees 2 on 1 lakh shares. Do not pay rupees 10, just pay rupees 2 on 1 lakh shares. So what will be the amount? 2 lakh. Clear? So when we have received applications, we received rupees 2 lakh along with the applications. Clear, friends? Now, once you have accepted applications, what is the next step? Allotment of shares. Allotment of shares. Now, at the time of allotment, what you will do is, that means you have accepted their applications. The first step you will do is, you will transfer the share application to share capital. You will transfer that amount into your capital. You will make your capital. Share application account debit to share capital account. Right? This signifies that we have accepted your applications and the money received at the time of application now becomes our capital. Right? Now, at the time of allotment, they say you have to bring rupees 4. When we have allotted you shares, we have accepted your application, At the time of allotment, you have to pay rupees 4 on 1 lakh shares. So what we'll do is, first we will make the amount due. We'll say share allotment account debit to share capital account. Right? How much? 4 lakh rupees. Rupees 4 on 1 lakh shares. This entry signifies that the amount is due at the time of allotment. Write this down. This is amount due on allotment. Right? This is amount due at the time of allotment. Now, we will receive this amount. If this amount is received, what will be the journal entry? Bank. Bank will be debited. And what will be credited to share? Allotment account. Clear? Clear, friends? So, can you see the net effect of these two entries? Here, debit share allotment 4 lakh. Here, credit share allotment 4 lakh. What is the net journal entry? Bank to share capital. Here, in this case also, what is the journal entry? Bank to share capital. Basically, we want to create capital. We are receiving money into bank. We want to create capital. That is what is the net effect of these entries. First of all, we will make the amount due on allotment, and then we will pass the journal entry for the receipt of allotment money. Clear? This much clear, friends? Now, they have paid 2 on application, 4 on allotment. So, what is the amount left? 4 rupees. So, after few days, they make a first and final call for 4 rupees. What will be the journal entry? Similar to allotment, what we will do? First, we will make the first and final call account debit to share capital. To share capital account. How much? 4 lakh and 4 lakh. Clear? First and final call account debit to share capital account 4 lakh. This is amount due on first and final call. Clear? First of all, we will make the amount due, that on this date, this amount is due towards the capital. Then, if you have received that amount, we will say bank account debit to first and final call. Clear? 4 lakh and 4 lakh. Clear, friends? This is how we issue shares in installments. That means we are not calling 10 rupees on 1 lakh shares. We are calling that money in divisions. We say pay rupees 2 at the time of applications. Send us the applications. Along with that, send rupees 2 on 1 lakh shares. Send rupees 2 lakh only. Do not send 10 lakh. Right? Then they say, when we accept your application, we allot you shares at the time of allotment, pay rupees 4 lakh. That is rupees 4 on 1 lakh shares. This is how you are going to read that. Clear? Then they say, we will make you a call and ask you to pay the remaining rupees 4. Clear, friends? This is how we do issue of shares in installments. The first one was issue of shares in lump sum, that is the total amount was received at the time of application. In case the shares are issued in installments, that means the face value is being called in installments. Face value, make a note here. These notes are important. These are going to help you in remembering the topics, right? In this case, face value of a share is called in investments. Clear? So, if it is in investments, what we are going to do? The first will be the bank to share application, that is the amount that has been received along with application. That is rupees 2 on 1 lakh shares. So we say bank to share application 2 lakh. When we have accepted the applications and we are ready to allot them the shares, the first step will be to transfer that application money to the share capital account. Why? Because we have received that money on application and now that money becomes our capital. This entry signifies that we have accepted the applications and the money that we have received, we are adjusting towards the capital. We are making it our capital. The net effect of the entry is bank to share capital. Clear? Then at the time of allotment, they say you have to pay rupees 4 at the time of allotment. First, what we are going to do is we are going to make the amount due. For that, the journal entry is share allotment account debit to share capital. This is amount due on allotment, and as soon as you receive the amount, we'll say bank to share allotment. The net effect of the entry is bank to share capital. Clear? See, the main aim is you have to raise the capital, right? You should get the money in your bank that becomes your capital and you are going to use that capital in the business. So the ultimate entry will be bank to share capital. That is the net effect of all the entries, right? Then you make the first and the final call for the remaining amount of 4 lakh rupees. So first, again, we will make the amount due. For that, the journal entry will be first and final call account debit to share capital. That is amount due on call. And as soon as you receive the amount, you will say bank to first and final call for rupees 4 lakh. Clear? So this is issue of shares in installments. Right? Now we have one more segment. Regarding issue of shares, it can be at par or at premium. What is the meaning of these two things? At par means issue of shares at their face value. At their face value. That is, you issue 1 lakh shares. You issue 1 lakh shares of rupees 10 each. So, what is the face value? This is the face value. Right? This is issue of shares at par. That is, 10 is the face value and you are issuing the shares at rupees 10 only. At premium means issue of shares at more than the face value. That means what is your face value? Rupees 10, and you are issued these shares at 5 rupees premium. Clear? That means you will receive on 1 lakh shares, right? Total is 15 rupees. You will receive out of this 10 is the face value and 5 is your premium. That means we are selling our shares at an amount more than the face value of the share. Clear? we are issuing the shares at an amount that is more than the face value of a share. Anything over and above the face value is called premium on share. Clear? This at par we have discussed, right? This is what we have discussed at par, that we issued the shares at their face value. The journal entries will remain the same. Now, how we are going to do the accounting treatment for issue of shares at premium, this we will discuss in the next lecture, right? So friends, if you have any queries, just send me an email at ksjteaching@gmail.com, right? So in the next lecture, what we are going to discuss is issue of shares at a premium. Issue of shares at premium. Right? So that's all for this lecture, friends. Thank you so much.